get this out of your way because it was supposed to be moved already.
Well, thank you. I didn't want to do it because it balances this one over here.
They're both just moving.
Hi, how are you? Where are you? Oh, okay. I didn't know if you might have a second to go to that same link and just to double check to make sure that's working. Okay. Yeah, yep. Okay, thanks. Bye. Hello. How's it been?
Good. How are you?
Good. Hello. Hi. Oh, good. Well, you see the picture of the big window. Okay. And then in a few seconds, you should hear me tapping on the microphone. Oh, well, there you go. Yeah. So it sounds pretty loud. Okay, good. You don't even have it that cranked. Okay. Yeah, but I still heard it. Okay. Well then, it's rolling, so it should. Oh, good. It says full, and it's supposed to be 8 hours. So. Yep. And I have another one here. If I had to switch it in the middle, and it's fully charged, but it doesn't last nearly as long. Yep. So we should be good. All right. Thanks. Okay. See ya. Bye.
Woody.
Yes. Actually, it's not videotaping. It's going to be broadcast.
Live?
Yeah. Yep.
How?
Well, it's right there.
Is it on the news?
Well, it's actually on the internet. So if anybody wants to go see it, they just click on it, and a window will come up, and they can watch
it. Is it a pop-up?
Kind of. It's, let's see if, I can find the page for it.
Are you in charge of St. Mark's whole thing?
No. No, I just do these kind of things for me. We do
so
videos.
So if I went in front of the camera, I'm...
Right now, you would be, yes. You could go and you could stand there. You could even say something to you. I'm not sure how many people will be watching. It's going out now, but yeah, most people will probably start watching at 5:30. But you can, if you stood up there and I put the camera on you, you go stand there once. Then you watch.
No, she goes out.
Yeah, see, watch. See how I'm moving the camera?
Mm-hmm.
There you go. And someone stands there.
No, you.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Okay. Post up. You go out there. Okay. Go ahead and I'll say, wait a minute now. Okay, now you see it?
Your turn.
Yep, go ahead. She did.
Wait,
it.
Do you
now
have
it's
a
your
Mac?
Turn. Yes, I do.
They're expensive. And I love the pad where you can just push it down.
Mm-hmm.
And then how smooth and silky it is.
Yeah. See?
Logan, you're being broadcast on the internet. Yeah, that will go on the internet.
Sure,
yeah, look. You
back.
See, look.
Ooh.
That's lovely.
That's what they're seeing on
That's
on
not
the
very good.
See right
That's
there?
Not very pretty.
Ew, smoke.
I don't want to get clean. Alright, let's stop.
Alright.
Alexis, did you see what I just did?
Alexis.
Whatever you do, don't. Oh my gosh, here they come.
Ooh, don't hit your head on it.
Santa Claus.
What?
Yeah. Look, you guys are fighting on the internet.
Yeah.
And now I'm to get her. Get her.
Oh,
no,
I got her.
Right. Oh,
man.
Oh,
my
thank you.
No catastrophes so far. No catastrophes like Easter so far. My computer died.
That's right.
I went in and got his, and he had just downloaded some software, and it had his. He said it had his computer all screwed. We didn't have a computer. We couldn't get a computer to work.
But we eventually got it.
I filmed it.
Oh.
I just filmed it on the camera. See, this camera is sending it out. And I didn't have the computer to broadcast it.
Oh.
So because of that, I just filmed it because I figured then we'd at least have a copy of it. Yeah.
Well, people saw it, though.
Well, he must have put it up on... They saw Christmas last year. This was Easter.
On Easter.
Yeah. When
I don't know what time it is.
It is 5:14.
Okay.
So what time do you start?
I'll start maybe a little bit before 5.
Before?
Or 5:30.
Okay. Because that's the only thing I won't know is how loud the organ will be for me to set. So once you start, I'll be able to set the audio levels because it's so much louder. So far, it's just people talking. So once you start, that'll give me a second.
Do you want me to play it or something?
No, that'll give me that. It'll take literally take me 5 seconds once you start.
Thank you.
perfectly in heaven, where with you and the Holy Spirit, he lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for the lesson.
Your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they sing for joy. For in faith sight they see the return of the Lord of Zion. Break forth together into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations. And all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the 96th Psalm. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his right hand and his holy arm, he has won for himself the victory. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And to the ends of the earth have we seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice, and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King, the Lord. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord. When he comes to judge the earth, in righteousness shall he judge the world, and the peoples with equity.
Thank you.
hearts and the words of my mouth be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our God and Redeemer. Amen. We have all the children that are here today come forward and sit with me up here on the steps. Okay, well, the other ones will be joining us. There we go, come on. Sit over here. It's a little harder for me to get down. There you go. Now, okay. I want to tell you a story. A story about a boy named Wilbur. You know a Wilbur? No? Okay. Well, Wilbur was a young boy who was in school, just like a lot of you are. You're in school?
Yeah.
You are? Good. Well, we're all in school. And Wilbur, he was a really nice boy. He did anything for anybody. He would be very helpful to his teachers. He would be very helpful to his classmates. Want to come sit down? Easier. There you go. When Wilbur was little, like everybody else was little, though, Wilbur was a little taller than everybody else, and he was a little bigger. But Wilbur also didn't like to study too much. He didn't do very good at numbers, didn't do very good at English. Your mom is. Yeah, I know your mom is probably very good at numbers. But Wilbur wasn't. So it came time to do a Christmas pageant, just like you folks just did. We're going to talk about Wilbur. You know Wilbur? No. Okay. Let's see. Here he is. Well, Wilbur didn't do too well in school. He had a hard time remembering things. That's why he had a hard time at school. So he was going to be the innkeeper. Now, we know the story about Jesus coming to us at Christmas. And one of the things was that Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem, just like you portrayed a minute ago, and they went to the inn where travelers stayed, and they asked the innkeeper, "Do you have a place for me?" And the innkeeper said, "What?" Do you remember the story?
No.
No. You don't remember the story, or the innkeeper said no? That's right. He said no because he said, "There's no more room in the inn. So you can't stay here, but I have a little place out in the barn." So Wilbur's part in the play was to remember these words. "There is no room in the inn, but you can sleep in the barn." Now that's not too hard to remember, is it? No. But for Wilbur, he had a hard time with it. So his teacher worked with him, and his mom worked with him, and he memorized it very slow. He went, "There is no room in the inn, but you can stay in the barn." Can you say that with me? There is no room in the inn, but you can stay in the barn. And Wilbur tried to remember that. What he would do is say it faster and faster until he could say it like he was supposed to say it. "There is no room for you in the inn, so you can stay in the barn." Can we do it that fast? "There is no room for you in the inn, so you can stay in the barn." And he was so proud of himself, he went home and he said that to his mother. His mother didn't have a clue what he was talking about. But she figured out that this must be for the Christmas play. So she was so proud of him, she gave him a big hug and a big kiss, and she was all ready to go and watch the play. Well, when the play came about, Mary and Joseph, rather than coming in the side door, they came down the long aisle in the church. And Wilbur was there in the back by the inn, and he got more and more nervous. The closer Mary and Joseph got to him, and they took a long time coming down that aisle.
He got more and more nervous, and he couldn't remember the words. He said, "Oh my gosh," to himself. He said, "I can't remember the words. I can't remember. What am I going to say?" And then all of a sudden, it started to come to him because he had practiced it so many times. He said, "Okay, I think there's no more room." Okay, and he's thinking and thinking and thinking. And all of a sudden, Joseph comes the way Joseph is supposed to, and he knocks on the door. Wilbur opens the door. And Joseph said, "My wife Mary is about to have a baby, probably tonight, so we need a room to stay." Of course, what was Wilbur supposed to say? "There is no room for you in the inn, but you can stay in the barn." Okay. But Wilbur got all mixed up. And he started saying, there is no room for me, no, for you in the, there's no room for you here, but you can stay in my room tonight." And he was so embarrassed because everybody laughed just like you did. They laughed. And he just, the rest of the play, Wilbur just looked down. He was so ashamed and so embarrassed. He just looked at the floor and looked at the floor. It was all over with. He was so afraid everybody was going to be mad at him. But his teacher came up to him, his Sunday school teacher, and said, "You know what, Wilbur? You got it right." He said, "I didn't get it right. I didn't say the right words." He said, "You didn't say the right words, but you got the message right." She said to him, "When you said to Mary and Joseph that they could stay in your room, that's exactly what we're supposed to do. Because when Jesus comes, he has to stay with us." So instead of telling them that there was no room for them, he said, "You can come and you can have my bed. You can come and sleep in my room. And I will go where? To the bar." And that's what Jesus really came to teach us, isn't it? That we would be kind to others and love each other so much that we would give up what we have so that the other person who has a greater need than we would have what they need. That's what Christmas is all about. So that's why everybody said to Wilbur, "You got it right. You maybe got the words wrong, but you got the message right." And that's what I hope we can do tonight. That we can remember that the message is not that there isn't any room for anyone here, but we can give up our place so that they can have a room for the night. Do you think we can remember that? Can you remember what Wilbur was supposed to say? Okay, now can you remember what Wilbur actually said?
Yes.
Okay, what did he say? "You can stay in my room." Can we say that all together? "There is no room here, but you can stay in my room." Maybe we can say a little prayer and say that to Jesus right now, okay? So let's close our eyes, bow our heads, and we'll say that to Jesus. "There is no room in the inn, but you can stay in my room." Amen. Okay, thank you. Go back to your seats. And perhaps that's a lesson for us, too. That in fact, rather than saying there is no place for people, that our house of God, our Bethel, is also a house of bread, Bethlehem, and that all are welcome here. All are welcome here. And we will make room for all. Let us stand together and profess our faith by saying together the Apostles' Creed, as it is found in your leaflet. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And so, my friends, on this dear Christmas night, may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. And also with you.
On behalf of the people and the ministry of St. Mark's Church, we'd like to wish you all a most happy and merry Christmas, a time when we think back about the origin of our faith, of how God became one of us so that he could share our life in every way, so that we might begin to share his life here among us. We don't have any announcements. This is the usual time for announcements, except to say Merry Christmas. And to tell you that if this is the first time that you're joining us, please know that what I said at the end of the children's sermon is exactly true. All are welcome here. And if you are searching for a spiritual home, please consider making St. Mark's your home. Now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself as an offering fragrant unto God.
Thank you.
the mighty power of the Holy Spirit, was made perfect man in the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin, and so receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast. Alleluia.
My brothers and sisters in the Episcopal Church, all who are baptized are welcome to receive Holy Communion at the rail. You may receive under the form of bread and wine, or one or the other, it makes no difference. You may stand or kneel, however it is most comfortable for you. If you are not comfortable receiving Holy Communion, you may still come forward with the assembly and ask for a blessing. We're glad that you are all here tonight. For now before you are the gifts of God given to the people of God. Take them, for Christ has died for you. Feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. Thank you. the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yeah, I called her earlier. This thing's just been...
Get it all in?
Yeah.
I tried to bring up.